Hello everyone. Today our topic is graph coloring. Graph coloring is the process of labeling graph components such as vertices, edges, and regions under some constraints. In a graph, no two adjacent vertices, adjacent edges, or adjacent regions are colored with the same color. A graph coloring problem is an NP-complete problem. Graph coloring is used in several applications. Some of these are map coloring, making timetable, bipartite graph checking, mobile radio frequency assignment, register allocation, data mining, image capturing, image segmentation, networking, resource allocation, process scheduling, and others. Graph coloring problem is both decision problem as well as an optimization problem. A decision problem is stated as, with given M colors and the graph G, whether such color scheme is possible or not. The optimization problem is stated as, given M colors and the graph G, find the minimum number of colors required for graph coloring. A coloring using at most K colors is called a proper K coloring, and a graph that can be assigned a proper K coloring is K colorable. The smallest number of colors needed to color a graph G is called its chromatic number, and a graph that is K-chromatic, if its chromatic number is exactly K. Next, vertex coloring. Vertex coloring is an assignment of colors to the vertices of a graph G such that no two adjacent vertices have the same color. Simply put, no two vertices of an edge should be of the same color. Again, the definition of chromatic number, the minimum number of colors required for vertex coloring of graph G is called the chromatic number of G, denoted by chi of G. Chi of G equals 1 if and only if G is a null graph, like in this graph. If G is not a null graph, then chi of G is greater than or equal to 2. For example, in all these graphs, chi of G equals 2. In this graph, we have two vertices, one blue, one green, in these three vertices, and to color them, we need two colors only. In this regular graph, also we need only two colors, blue, green, blue, green. The problem can be solved by assigning a unique color to each vertex, but this solution is not optimal. It may be possible to color the graph with colors less than the number of vertices. For example, in this graph, we can assign to each vertex a unique color. The number of colors, chi of G in this case equals 5, but this solution is not optimal. We can color this graph only using two colors, chi of G equals 2. A blue, a green, a blue, a green, and here a blue. So the optimal solution uses two colors instead of 5. Again, we can color this regular graph as follows, a blue, blue, red, red. If we have a cyclic graph, we can color this blue, and this blue, and the other vertices red. So again, we only need two colors. In this graph, we have a cycle of 5 vertices, blue, here blue, red, red. Now we are stuck here. We cannot color this vertex with the blue or with the red, so we need a third color. In this cyclic graph, we have 7 vertices. Blue, here blue, here blue. Red, red, red. Again here, we need a third color. So in general, cyclic graphs with even number of vertices require only two colors, chi of G equals 2. And cyclic graph with odd number of vertices require 3 colors, chi of G equals 3. Example, find the chromatic number for Peterson graph. In Peterson graph, we have 10 vertices, 5 of them external and 5 internal. The external vertices form a cycle, and each external vertex is connected to one internal vertex. and the internal vertices are connected in a star manner, like this. We already know that we have an odd cycle, then we need three colors. Here, red, blue, green, red, blue. Now regarding this vertex, it's adjacent to this colored vertex, so we can color this vertex with the blue. This vertex is connected to these vertices. So we can choose here green and here red. This vertex is connected to blue vertex and to green vertex. So we can color it with red. The last vertex here is connected with the blue vertex and with the red vertices. So we can color it with the green. So the chromatic number for Peterson graph is 3. We only need 3 colors to color the 10 vertices so that no adjacent vertices are colored with the same color. Next, coloring complete graphs. In the complete graph, each vertex is adjacent to remaining n minus 1 vertices. So if we color this vertex with the green, this with the blue, we cannot use these two colors, here red and here, for example, yellow. In the same manner, in the K5 graph here, we have to use 5 different colors. So in the complete graph, every vertex requires a new color. Hence, in K incomplete graph, the chromatic number is n. Procedure to color a graph. Input a graph with n vertices. Step 1. Arrange the vertices of the graph in some order. Step 2. Choose the first vertex and color it with the first color. Step 3. Choose the next vertex and color it with the lowest numbered color that has not been colored when any vertex is adjacent to it. If all the adjacent vertices are colored with this color, assign a new color to it. Repeat this step until all the vertices are colored. Next, Brock's theorem. Brock's theorem states that a connected graph can be colored with only X colors, where X is the maximum degree of any vertex in the graph, except for complete graphs and the graphs containing an odd length cycle, which requires X plus 1 colors. Color this graph. We can start with red. Here we have to use another color, blue, for example. Here we need another color, green, for example. For this vertex, we can use blue. And for this vertex, we can use red. So we need 3 colors. Note the degrees. The degree here is 3. The degree here is 3. The degree here is 2. The degree here is 3. And the degree here is 3. The maximum degree is 3. So Brock's theorem is valid for this graph. In this graph, we have odd cycle, and we already know that we need 3 colors. Here green, red, red. For this vertex, we need a new color. So we need 3 colors. The maximum degree here is 2. All the degrees are equal. 2 plus 1 equals 3. In the same manner, in this complete graph, the maximum degree equals 1, 2, 3, 4. All degrees are equal. So we need 5 colors. All the colors are different since any node is connected to all other nodes. So in this K5 graph, we need 5 colors for plus 1. In the K6 complete graph, we need 6 colors to color any vertex. Next example, prove Brock's theorem for the given graph. We can use Brock's theorem to find the minimum number of colors to color a graph. We can color this graph as follows. Here red for this vertex, another color for this vertex as well, and also for this vertex. For this vertex, we can use green. And for this vertex, we can use blue. So the chromatic number for this graph, chi of g, equals 4. Now the degrees. The degree here is 3. The degree for this vertex 3, for this vertex 2, for this vertex the degree is 3, and for this vertex the degree is 4. The maximum degree equals 4. Therefore, chi of g also equals 4. Thus, this graph proves Brock's theorem. Brock's theorem helps us to find directly chi of g, the chromatic number for the graph. We find the vertex with maximum degree, and that degree will be chi of g. Next, grid coloring. Grid coloring considers the vertices of the graph in sequence and assigns each vertex its first available color, i.e., vertices are considered in a specific order, v1, v2, etc., vn, and vi is assigned the smallest available color, which is not used by any of vi's neighbors. For example, if we apply greedy coloring to this K3-3 bipartite graph, then depending on the ordering, we may obtain the following scenario. But we know that in bipartite graphs, we have two sets, V1 and V2, and any vertex in set V1 is not connected to any vertex in this set, and any vertex in set V2 is not connected to any vertex in this set. So for bipartite graphs, we need only two colors. This means that greedy coloring does not always guarantee the optimal solution. For a graph of maximum degree X, greedy coloring will use at most X plus one color. One strategy used to solve the coloring problem is backtracking. The vertex coloring can be solved using backtracking as follows. List down all the vertices and colors in two lists. Assign color 1 to vertex 1. If vertex 2 is not adjacent to vertex 1, then assign to it the same color. Otherwise, assign color 2. Repeat the process until all vertices are colored. Algorithm backtracks whenever color I is not possible to assign to any vertex K, and it selects the next color, I plus 1, and test is repeated. So instead of using the complete space tree, we apply a bound condition. The backtracking algorithm is illustrated in more detail in the algorithm's design and analysis course. Next, region coloring. Region coloring is an assignment of colors to the regions of a planar graph such that not two adjacent regions have the same color. Two regions are said to be adjacent if they have a common edge. For example, we can color the regions in this graph as follows. If we use here green, here for example, blue, note we can use blue here, and we can use blue here. So to color the regions in this graph, we need only two colors. Next, the four-color theorem. The four-color theorem, or the four-color map theorem, states that no more than four colors are required to color the regions of any map so that no two adjacent regions have the same color. Adjacent means that two regions share a common boundary curve segment, not merely a corner where three or more regions meet. This theorem was the first major theorem to be proved using a computer. Initially, this computer approved was not widely accepted by mathematicians. Next, edge coloring. Edge coloring is similar to vertex coloring. Each edge of a graph has a color assigned to it in such a way that no two adjacent edges are of the same color. Such a coloring is a proper edge coloring. With cyclic graphs, the analogy becomes an equivalence as there are an edge vertex duality. In general, however, the chromatic number is not related to the minimal KK such that a proper HKK coloring exists. For today, that's all. Thank you.